Hey you guys, it's SB1057 making another vlog for you. I'm so sorry about making the video so late, but you know, it's been quite a crazy week. But you know what? I thought for this video, I'm just going to talk about why I'm so annoyed today. Why I've been so annoyed not only today, but for the entire, like, forever. Okay, so how many of you have actually, like, gone on and try to watch like a TV show online because you missed it, and all these extra screens pop up, and on the side panel it's like 1 in 4 relationships, Love Life, Match.com, or whatever they're called, but it's like, I just want to watch a video. Okay, so here's what I'm confused about. What is the actual scene? Do people really talk about this stuff? What is on their mind? So this is what I did for you guys, you know, because I can sit here and rant about it all day, but I actually went onto my campus. That's right. You know, I mean, I always like to stay in my dorm and make these videos, but this time I'm like, I gotta step out of my comfort zone. I went on campus and interviewed all these different people, like from the different faculties. I go to a campus which has over 60,000 kids, so you can imagine the diversity that we've got. Went to the engineering building, to sciencey kids, to math kids, business kids. We have a business school, if you guys didn't know. But anyways, I want you to see what you think. Tweet me, Facebook me, like me, send me a video response, because you know I love those. So yeah, tell me what you guys think. And so here's the thing. I spent the entire day, you know, I was so tired walking from campus to campus. I mean, faculty to faculty. I mean, not campus to campus. So it occurred at York University, for those who don't know who where I go. But I'm pretty sure if you've been following me, I always talk about what's happening on campus and stuff. So I just talked to my peers, and okay, I'm going to give it to you right now. You know what? Take a look. Show me the meaning of being lonely. Is this the feeling I need to walk with? Tell me why I can't be there where you are. There's something missing in my heart. It never ends. Eyes of stone observe the trends. They never say forever gaze. If only a beauty rose to an endless love. There's no control. Are you with me now?
Relationships and dating are the same thing.
I think they're different.
Any reason why you think they're different?
Because dating someone is just going out on a date, no harm getting to know them. But if you're in a relationship, you have a title.
Title? Okay.
And you have rules.
Like, relationship seems more that you've formed a bond with a person and that, you know, you've got that strong bond. And relationship doesn't have to do anything with dating. Or it could, depending if you're purchasing long term. And dating just seems you're trying to find an intimacy with a person, and there's more than just friendless relationship there. Both of them can go long term. One can go 5 different ways of love. The other only has 2.
You know what? It really depends on the person. Because if you look at some individuals, whereas they feel that they'll be dating for a longer time, they'll need to go through multiple processes. It's like drafting up who they feel they want to spend time with. Because there's a difference between a relationship and someone you're seeing. Because at a certain point, you may see 8 people at the same time, and a few you may write off right at the start, and then you'll have 4, and it keeps going, kind of like a tournament, until eventually being in a relationship is some kind of solemn promise that it's exclusive almost.
Okay, so let me get this straight. So they do think there's a distinct distinction between dating and relationship. Majority of the folks seem to think so. You know what? I do really believe them. I think just by watching them and their behavior and their thought process, they seem to really define with concrete evidence of what they think is the difference. And I really seem to think that, you know, they've actually thought about this before, or that's just what their views are. So it's pretty darn cool. Let's see what everyone else has to say.
It's time.
Which is usually why you usually like find someone in your program or someone who someone who understands the schedule, because like regular relationships, like, it's hard to make them last with a schedule like this. So, like, good luck to Dan.
Yes.
I'm saying, like, congrats to be able to do that, because it's, like, in certain programs, I don't know how relationships really last. And, like, it's like, okay, we have 1 hour together this week. It's like,
yeah.
It's
pretty much what it was like last year.
Yeah.
I was in a relationship, but rehearsal, like the one time a week we could hang out,
yeah.
I've got rehearsals.
Yeah.
So, didn't work out.
Yeah.
I have friends who are in relationships. I don't have any friends who are dating right now.
Like, for example, in North America, it's more like you date someone and then you get to know them more. But like in Asia, like South Asia, you just like get committed, like if someone asks you.
Like, university really isn't, like, a place for successful relationships, like, going into it. Like, it's really hard as, it's just really complex. And, like, not a lot of people are really fond of the idea. And it's really hard to find two people who are willing to put themselves in that situation.
People tend to get into serious relationships once they're in, like, college or university. Because I feel like when you're in high school, you're a bit more mature. So... some of them have lasted, surprisingly, but majority of them are from university and colleges. They meet, you know, from within their program, their field of interest, and depends on kind of people they're interested in. Like, for example, personally, I would probably go for somebody within my field because I want to do medicine, and or like business, whatever it is. Like, two fields that I'm really, really, like, you know, interested in.
Okay, so personal experiences, you know what? I think there seems to be a really big divide in how they either view their friends or view themselves. I don't know. I don't know if I really trust what they're saying. I think I need to investigate further to really dig in.
Will you be searching for true love today?
Incoming contact.
good question. I would feel like, I don't know, like hesitant.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't think I need it. That's creepy. No.
Yeah, that's... nope.
Maybe through Facebook, I guess.
Yeah, not like those online dating sites.
Yeah, like
not
you are.
Yeah, you are.
I'm pretty open to it. I don't know if I'd use it myself, but...
What? Does Facebook count? I know some people meet each other on Facebook. I'm being honest.
Oh yeah, I met my boyfriend on YouTube.
I love him to death.
I mean, I wouldn't mind giving it a shot, but you know, it'd have to be something that caters to my needs. It had to be something.
What are your needs?
Something that's not cheesy and, you know, something that's not traditional. I mean, you get the regular dating sites, you know, everywhere where you can just go online and, you know, you have the pictures of girls who are, you know, almost naked and, you know, you try and like... you know, that's something I'd like, you know, I mean, it's good, but it's just something, you know, if I'm if I'd be going that way online dating, you know, I'm not looking for something, I'm not looking for porn, you know, but I'm looking for something like, you know, like somebody I can date. So I'd look for something, you know, where people would be in a gathering, kind of like myself, and you know, something that's casual, something that's not traditional and too, like, you know, cheesy.
You need to be careful of, obviously, you know, online predators and whatnot, but there's no thing that ever has a break between you and finding someone online, because just because there's distance between you doesn't mean that there isn't a connection.
I think it's fine, but you just have to be careful in the way, like, who you meet and, like, how are you meeting them.
My friend has met someone online.
Through actually. Dating services or...
like, something like that, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, she actually, like, he ended up being a pimp.
What? Okay.
Should I say this?
It's okay. It's okay.
Okay.
You can say anything you want.
Oh, he ended up being a pimp, and then he like kind of forced her, or like got her like to like really like him, and like with like words, I guess, or like material objects, and he got her to pursue like stripping and dancing and stuff like that. From someone that she just met online, so it's pretty...
That's crazy.
Crazy.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
No. Wait, no. Yeah, there is one. Well, like, there's this guy that stalked another girl on Facebook, and then they started talking, and they're dating now for like 2 years, but like it's really complex. So
I think it's dangerous. It's risky. It's really, really, really risky because like you don't know the person. So why would you do it?
Unless you're really desperate. I don't know how to play.
Quite interesting. I think the responses for online dating were quite reasonable. I mean, a lot of people said, I don't know. It's creepy. I would never do it. I'm hesitant. This Facebook account, I met my boyfriend on YouTube. It's risky. It's for those who are desperate. But some of them presented really good on ideas and their thought process. You know what? You have to take precautions. You don't know what you're getting into. You might get persuaded into, you know, things like the girl mentioned the guy was a pimp. Okay, let's slow it down a little.
Love will find a way anywhere I go. I'm home if you are there beside me.
Need something from school? I guess one of the negatives is that for me personally, like, I guess you kind of entitled to see them all the time. And I'm the kind of guy, like, if I'm in a relationship, I kind of, like, don't want to see the person, like, 24-7. But apart from that, it's pretty cool.
So
like,
you need your really space, mind. Right? Like, need
kind of thing, yeah. I need, like, a break, but not too much of a break, obviously. Like, I still want to see them.
Or, like, out in the beautiful day like this, you want to sit by the fountain.
Of course. I mean, how romantic is that?
I date someone from campus, so it's nice if you have a place to crash. yeah, that's the only reason. No.
Actually, it is hard though. I don't meet that many gay guys on campus. Not that many. I maybe met like 10 in the 4 years I've been here.
There's been a fair amount of like dating on campus that I know of, and it's whatever. I feel like if you're too close, like, if you're too within the same vicinity of someone, it gets kind of annoying, especially like when you're trying to figure out who you are.
Okay, so I think I'm starting to understand their thought processes of what they're saying about dating on campus. I mean, you know, some of them were like, you know, it's nice to have somebody close, nice to meet somebody, you know, within the same school. There's, you know, a greater selection, or the one said added bonus of having a place to crash. Hold on, buddy.
Late, remember the first time we met, you was at the mall with your friend. I was scared to approach her, but then you came closer, hoping you
so
would give me a
chance. So that pretty girl walking right behind me, are you crazy for her right now?
Man, no way, hell, that girl's, oh, no way, I would never have
she's
the
guts. She's got three looks, so what, like?
I would never have the guts to go talk to that girl. I mean, I need something like online dating to help me out.
No, I would freeze myself.
Yeah, same.
Okay with it.
It depends, because sometimes, like, you don't want to give them the wrong impression, because, like, when you approach a girl, that it's kind of like saying you only want to talk to them because of their looks, but sometimes it's better just to meet them through, like, a friendship or, like, just getting to know their personality, because, like, you don't want to start off on the wrong note by, like, going straight after infatuation. Something like that. Yeah,
yeah, we're good.
I'm actually not the type of guy to approach. I'm a little more reserved and a little more shy. Like, I like to get to know them, be friends first, and then see where it goes from there.
Okay, so after going through the videos and like watching everybody, you know, say what they want to say and speak their mind, I was like, I know somebody I can reach out to, like the love guru. You know, somebody who's been following me and always sends, you know, great responses to questions that I have. So you know what? I reached out to them and kind of wanted to know if they can make any conclusions, because, you know, I'm not an expert myself and they claim to be, you know, one of the craziest love gurus on the planet. So I'm going to let you listen in and take a look and see what you think. Love Guru 5335 checking in from my girl SB, who's asked me to help her out. Alright, so according to my observations, my science, love, and tific observations, I can actually make practical, actionable conclusions about a gap in the marketplace. Alright, so I find these university students are kind of confused about, you know, whether they want to meet somebody on campus and start a relationship. I feel like there's a lot of time management issues.
Okay, we have 1 hour together this week.
Relationship success issues.
Like, university really isn't like a place for successful relationships. Like,
there's no on-campus dating service. Students like the idea of variety and selection, preferring to date somebody in their own faculty because they feel like they can connect.
I would probably go for somebody within my field because I want to do medicine.
They identify as difficult to meet people on campus that, you know, about their needs, whether it's their religion or, you know, preferred sexuality. And I find like the idea of online dating was like, it's creepy. You know?
That's creep. No.
Yeah, that's...
nope. They feel like the online dating doesn't allow all these options to have a secure relationship or to meet somebody. And I feel like they're more comfortable meeting somebody through mutual friends. And so, you know what? Some of them are hesitant, but were open to the idea of meeting somebody online through secure ways. So you know what? Those are some of the conclusions I just had. Okay, so Love Guru 3550, you would like to take a moment to reflect on my perspective on this issue. You know, I feel like online dating is an emerging trend. I feel that, you know, really allows students to accommodate with their lifestyle. But there's a parent gap. There's a, you know, the gap is risky. Students do not like the idea of it. They want critical issues to be addressed, like meeting like-minded people who are there compatible with. You know, there's two opportunities that I can really address. People want to meet individuals like themselves, same interests, same faculty, whether you go to the Schulich School of Business, whether you go to Atkinson, whether you go to, you know, the ones next to those buildings. Now think about it, other people also want to meet people from other faculties. Nursing joins engineering. You know, they want to get out of their comfort zone. So that's really my, you know, perspective on it. Now, is it a trend, part of a movement or a fad? How do you say this? What should you keep in mind? Okay, this is an opportunity. I'd like to stress as Love Guru 5335, it is not a fad. Dating is always in fashion. People want to get out, pursue a relationship, or just get to meet new people. Okay, so now I'd like to take this moment to reach out to SB, my girl, my video vlog girl, and let her know some of these ideas that just came upon me. You know, I was pondering the issues and I thought, okay, why not have a sit down and a moment to think about three ideas. First one, why not come up with an online dating student website? You know, people are more comfortable talking online than in person since they're already, you know, sometimes too shy. This way is an effective way to match and find compatibility between people. Just an idea. Idea number two. Why not have a campus matchmaking, you know, where you fill out a couple of questions, you do some algorithms to figure out whether you're compatible with somebody, set you up with a date, almost like a blind date. Just as idea number two. Idea number three, you know, sort of like campus speed dating. You know, you find a bunch of people that you're compatible with. Just think about it, you know, SB, you think about it. A bunch of people you're compatible with. And to organize this, you firstly have to fill out some questions, some algorithms to figure out what you're looking for, what your needs are, what your interests are, what your hobbies are. And then narrow it down to, you know, like almost like an info session. Schulich kids have that. Info session where all these candidates come together. It's like speed dating, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, quickly going through them, asking them questions. And at the end, if you like somebody, you pursue it, but not necessarily, you know, in an unsafe environment. I mean, this could be in your local pub at York Lanes or something, you know, in a nice and friendly way is what I'm saying. Just some ideas, three of them for you.
Oh, I wish this could be.
was quite interesting. You know, there's a lot of information I'm going to take in, but you know, I've really come up with my strategy, I guess, for you guys is to really come up with a plan of how I'm going to be testing these concepts. So I've come up with a few, you know, taking into account you know, things that are actually doable. I'm going to, you know, be serving students across the faculty, sort of to get an understanding of, you know, maybe their responses might be a little bit different, you know, off camera, to see what their written responses will be in terms of the ideas that a love guru had presented to me. You know, I want to also interview and perhaps do some focus groups with different students from different faculties, just to get a better understanding of, you know, their likes and their dislikes, and just to assess that in terms of a smaller group in a contained environment. And you know, after I've done, you know, some really good research on their ideas and their assessments, I'm going to come up with a way to perhaps pilot these ideas, maybe take a small group sample size and you know, try the idea of matchmaking to see if they like, you know, they like the services. Try the idea of you know, sort of setting up some sort of questions online, whether they'd be comfortable with that interface, and really just focus on you know, the needs of the people. So I'm going to try the three ideas that the Love Guru had mentioned, and you know what, I'm going to get right back out there on campus, start interviewing, and I can't wait to make another video vlog with you guys. I think it'll be exciting. So tell me what you think. If you have any questions, just message me the link below. See you next time. Signing off.